A supercritical fluid, SCF, is any substance at a temperature and pressure above its critical point, where distinct liquid and gas phases do not exist, but below the pressure required to compress it into a solid. It can effuse through porous solids like a gas, overcoming the mass transfer limitations that slow liquid transport through such materials. SCF are much superior to gases in their ability to dissolve materials like liquids or solids. In addition, close to the critical point, small changes in pressure or temperature result in large changes in density, allowing many properties of a supercritical fluid to be fine-tuned. Supercritical fluids occur in the atmospheres of the gas giants Jupiter and Saturn, the terrestrial planet Venus, and probably in those of the ice giants Uranus and Neptune. Supercritical water is found on Earth, such as the water issuing from black smokers, a type of underwater hydrothermal vent. They are used as a substitute for organic solvents in a range of industrial and laboratory processes. Carbon dioxide and water are the most commonly used supercritical fluids. They are often used for decaffeination and power generation, respectively. Natural occurrence. Hydrothermal circulation. Hydrothermal circulation occurs within the Earth's crust wherever fluid becomes heated and begins to convect. These fluids are thought to reach supercritical conditions under a number of different settings, such as in the formation of porphyry copper deposits or high-temperature circulation of seawater in the seafloor. At mid-ocean ridges, this circulation is most evident by the appearance of hydrothermal vents known as black smokers. These are large, meters high, chimneys of sulfide and sulfate minerals which vent fluids up to 400 degrees Celsius. The fluids appear like great black billowing clouds of smoke due to the precipitation of dissolved metals in the fluid. It is likely that at depth many of these vent sites reach supercritical conditions, but most cool sufficiently by the time they reach the seafloor to be subcritical. One particular vent site, Turtle Pits, has displayed a brief period of supercriticality at the vent site. A further site, Beebe, in the Cayman Trough, is thought to display sustained supercriticality at the vent orifice. Planetary atmospheres. The atmosphere of Venus has 96.5% carbon dioxide and 3.5% nitrogen. The surface pressure is 9.3 megapascals, 93 bars, and the surface temperature is 735 kelvins, above the critical points of both major constituents and making the surface atmosphere a supercritical fluid. The interior atmospheres of the solar system's gas giant planets are composed mainly of hydrogen and helium at temperatures well above their critical points. The gaseous outer atmospheres of Jupiter and Saturn transition smoothly into the dense liquid interior, while the nature of the transition zones of Neptune and Uranus is unknown. Theoretical models of extrasolar planet Gliese 876d have posited an ocean of pressurized, supercritical fluid water with a sheet of solid high-pressure water ice at the bottom. Applications. Supercritical fluid extraction. The advantages of supercritical fluid extraction, compared with liquid extraction, are that it is relatively rapid because of the low viscosities and high diffusivities associated with supercritical fluids. The extraction can be selective to some extent by controlling the density of the medium, and the extracted material is easily recovered by simply depressurizing, allowing the supercritical fluid to return to gas phase and evaporate, leaving little or no solvent residues. Carbon dioxide is the most common supercritical solvent. It is used on a large scale for the decaffeination of green coffee beans, the extraction of hops for beer production, and the production of essential oils and pharmaceutical products from plants. A few laboratory test methods include the use of supercritical fluid extraction as an extraction method instead of using traditional solvents. Supercritical fluid decomposition. Supercritical water can be used to decompose biomass via supercritical water gasification of biomass. This type of biomass gasification can be used to produce hydrocarbon fuels for use in an efficient combustion device or to produce hydrogen for use in a fuel cell. In the latter case, hydrogen yield can be much higher than the hydrogen content of the biomass due to steam reforming, where water is a hydrogen providing participant in the overall reaction. Dry cleaning. Supercritical carbon dioxide, SCD, can be used instead of PERC, perchloroethylene, or other undesirable solvents for dry cleaning. Supercritical carbon dioxide sometimes intercalates into buttons, and, when the SCD is depressurized, the buttons pop or break apart. Detergents that are soluble in carbon dioxide improve the solvating power of the solvent. CO2-based dry cleaning equipment uses liquid CO2, not supercritical CO2, to avoid damage to the buttons. Supercritical fluid chromatography. Supercritical fluid chromatography, SFC, can be used on an analytical scale, where it combines many of the advantages of high-performance liquid chromatography, HPLC, and gas chromatography, GC. It can be used with non-volatile and thermally labile analytes, unlike GC, and can be used with the universal flame ionization detector, unlike HPLC, as well as producing narrower peaks due to rapid diffusion. In practice, the advantages offered by SFC have not been sufficient to displace the widely used HPLC and GC, except in a few cases such as chiral separations and analysis of high molecular weight hydrocarbons. For manufacturing, efficient preparative simulated moving bed units are available. The purity of the final products is very high, but the cost makes it suitable only for very high-value materials such as pharmaceuticals. Chemical reactions. Changing the conditions of the reaction solvent can allow separation of phases for product removal or single phase for reaction. Rapid diffusion accelerates diffusion-controlled reactions. Temperature and pressure can tune the reaction down preferred pathways, e.g., to improve yield of a particular chiral isomer. There are also significant environmental benefits over conventional organic solvents. Industrial syntheses that are performed at supercritical conditions include those of polyethylene from supercritical ethene, isopropyl alcohol from supercritical propene, 2-butanol from supercritical butene, and ammonia from a supercritical mix of nitrogen and hydrogen. Other reactions were, in the past, performed industrially in supercritical conditions, including the synthesis of methanol and thermal, non-catalytic, oil cracking. Because of the development of effective catalysts, the required temperatures of those two processes have been reduced and are no longer supercritical. Impregnation and dyeing. Impregnation is, in essence, the converse of extraction. A substance is dissolved in the supercritical fluid, the solution flowed past a solid substrate, and is deposited on or dissolves in the substrate. Dyeing, which is readily carried out on polymer fibers such as polyester using disperse, non-ionic dyes, is a special case of this. Carbon dioxide also dissolves in many polymers, considerably swelling and plasticizing them and further accelerating the diffusion process. Nano and microparticle formation. The formation of small particles of a substance with a narrow size distribution is an important process in the pharmaceutical and other industries. Supercritical fluids provide a number of ways of achieving this by rapidly exceeding the saturation point of a solute by dilution, depressurization, or a combination of these. These processes occur faster in supercritical fluids than in liquids, promoting nucleation or spinodal decomposition over crystal growth and yielding very small and regularly sized particles. Recent supercritical fluids have shown the capability to reduce particles up to a range of 5 to 2000 nanometers. Generation of pharmaceutical co-crystals. Supercritical fluids act as a new media for the generation of novel crystalline forms of APIs, active pharmaceutical ingredients, named as pharmaceutical co-crystals. Supercritical fluid technology offers a new platform that allows a single-step generation of particles that are difficult or even impossible to obtain by traditional techniques. The generation of pure and dried new co-crystals, crystalline molecular complexes comprising the API and one or more conformers in the crystal lattice, can be achieved due to unique properties of SCFs by using different supercritical fluid properties, supercritical CO2 solvent power, anti-solvent effect and its atomization enhancement. Supercritical drying. Supercritical drying is a method of removing solvent without surface tension effects. As a liquid dries, the surface tension drags on small structures within a solid, causing distortion and shrinkage. Under supercritical conditions, there is no surface tension, and the supercritical fluid can be removed without distortion. Supercritical drying is used in the manufacturing process of aerogels and drying of delicate materials such as archaeological samples and biological samples for electron microscopy. Supercritical water electrolysis. Electrolysis of water in a supercritical state reduces the overpotentials found in other electrolyzers, thereby improving the electrical efficiency of the production of oxygen and hydrogen. Increased temperature reduces thermodynamic barriers and increases kinetics. No bubbles of oxygen or hydrogen are formed on the electrodes, therefore no insulating layer is formed between catalyst and water, reducing the ohmic losses. The gas-like properties provide rapid mass transfer. Supercritical water oxidation. Supercritical water oxidation uses supercritical water as a medium in which to oxidize hazardous waste, eliminating production of toxic combustion products that burning can produce. The waste product to be oxidized is dissolved in the supercritical water along with molecular oxygen, or an oxidizing agent that gives up oxygen upon decomposition, e.g. hydrogen peroxide, at which point the oxidation reaction occurs. Supercritical water hydrolysis. Supercritical hydrolysis is a method of converting all biomass polysaccharides as well the associated lignin into low molecular compounds by contacting with water alone under supercritical conditions. The supercritical water acts as a solvent, a supplier of bond-breaking thermal energy, a heat transfer agent, and as a source of hydrogen atoms. All polysaccharides are converted into simple sugars in near quantitative yield in a second or less. The aliphatic interring linkages of lignin are also readily cleaved into free radicals that are stabilized by hydrogen originating from the water. The aromatic rings of the lignin are unaffected under short reaction times, so that the lignin-derived products are low molecular weight mixed phenols. To take advantage of the very short reaction times needed for cleavage, a continuous reaction system must be devised. The amount of water heated to a supercritical state is thereby minimized. Supercritical water gasification. Supercritical water gasification is a process of exploiting the beneficial effect of supercritical water to convert aqueous biomass streams into clean water and gases like H2, CH4, Colorado2, Colorado, etc. Supercritical fluid in power generation. The efficiency of a heat engine is ultimately dependent on the temperature difference between heat source and sink, Carnot cycle. To improve efficiency of power stations, the operating temperature must be raised. Using water as the working fluid, this takes it into supercritical conditions. Efficiencies can be raised from about 39% for subcritical operation to about 45% using current technology. Supercritical water reactors, SCWRs, are promising advanced nuclear systems that offer similar thermal efficiency gains. Carbon dioxide can also be used in supercritical cycle nuclear power plants with similar efficiency gains. Many coal-fired supercritical steam generators are operational all over the world and have enhanced the efficiency of traditional steam power plants. Biodiesel production. Conversion of vegetable oil to biodiesel is via a transesterification reaction, where the triglyceride is converted to the methyl ester plus glycerol. This is usually done using methanol and caustic or acid catalysts, but can be achieved using supercritical methanol without a catalyst. The method of using supercritical methanol for biodiesel production was first studied by Saka and his co-workers. This has the advantage of allowing a greater range in water content of feedstocks, in particular, used cooking oil. The product does not need to be washed to remove catalyst, and is easier to design as a continuous process. Enhanced oil recovery and carbon capture and storage. Supercritical carbon dioxide is used to enhance oil recovery in mature oil fields. At the same time, there is the possibility of using clean coal technology to combine enhanced recovery methods with carbon sequestration. The CO2 is separated from other flue gases, compressed to the supercritical state, and injected into geological storage, possibly into existing oil fields to improve yields. At present, only schemes isolating fossil CO2 from natural gas actually use carbon storage, e.g., Sleipner gas field, but there are many plans for future CCS schemes involving pre- or post-combustion CO2. There is also the possibility to reduce the amount of CO2 in the atmosphere by using biomass to generate power and sequestering the CO2 produced. Enhanced geothermal system. The use of supercritical carbon dioxide, instead of water, has been examined as a geothermal working fluid. Refrigeration. Supercritical carbon dioxide is also emerging as a useful high-temperature refrigerant, being used in new, CFC, HFC-free domestic heat pumps making use of the transcritical cycle. These systems are undergoing continuous development, with supercritical carbon dioxide heat pumps already being successfully marketed in Asia. The EcoCute systems from Japan are some of the first commercially successful high-temperature domestic water heat pumps. Supercritical fluid deposition. Supercritical fluids can be used to deposit functional nanostructured films and nanometer-sized particles of metals onto surfaces. The high diffusivities and concentrations of precursor in the fluid as compared to the vacuum systems used in chemical vapor deposition allow deposition to occur in a surface reaction rate limited regime, providing stable and uniform interfacial growth. This is crucial in developing more powerful electronic components, and metal particles deposited in this way are also powerful catalysts for chemical synthesis and electrochemical reactions. Additionally, due to the high rates of precursor transport in solution, it is possible to coat high surface area particles which under chemical vapor deposition would exhibit depletion near the outlet of the system and also be likely to result in unstable interfacial growth features such as dendrites. The result is very thin and uniform films deposited at rates much faster than atomic layer deposition, the best other tool for particle coating at this size scale. Antimicrobial properties. CO2 at high pressures has antimicrobial properties. While its effectiveness has been shown for various applications, the mechanisms of inactivation have not been fully understood, although they have been investigated for more than 60 years.